открыли, эти 30 человек заняло 10 минут. Через 10 минут это зашлось. Ну, я смотрел, большинство с собой берут. Типа что, на шару, типа, наверное, не голодные, просто пришел, взял, а вечерком там перед телевизором там, сел и херачит. Че не можешь найти? Ну как мне билет? На веб-сайт. Залезть на веб-сайт там. Вот. Grill.com там. Не, я пробовал так найти, не нахожу. Просто идешь на веб-сайт, открываешь, и там что-то написано, там back to community, что-то такое. Там кликнешь, там написано, что мы там back to community. Они тоже крученые, что free burger не стали писать, а то, блядь, все ломанутся. А так замаскировались, типа. И чарите, но им тоже 1000 человек не нужно, чтобы пришли, представь. А я там... Я там Джанки одного встретил, говорю, ну что, идешь? Да, я иду, типа, иду я. Такой шепотом. А я говорю, что ты шепотом? Да я не хочу, чтобы никто не знал. Говорю, так ты хоть друзьям сказал, нахуй какие друзья, типа. Скажешь им потом. А? Да, Local Matters. Ну там еще что-то, если кликнешь на Local Matters, там еще что-то там, по-моему, back to community, там что-то такое. Да. Нашел. Сухам не рис. А, кто это опять? Амей. Он, наверное, в Сиднее, может, в Мельбурне. В Брисбене, наверное, нету. Там все богатые. В Брисбене все богатые, у них дома со свиными пулами. Там нехуй кормить. Идите купайтесь, плавайте. Мне пишут, и мне Джанки сказали. А Джанки все знают, типа. Но они меня уважают, мне сказали, но друзьям даже не говорят. Это вот, куда я в хор хожу, этот Sydney Street Choir. Это мне там человека три, типа, на ухо. Я говорю, так а что ты выделал микрофон, объявил, нахуй не нужны, типа, самим мало, типа, это только, ну, приходи, я тебе говорю, но больше никому не скажу, пиздец, как это, шпионские страсти, типа, так я вот а что, ты приехал, да? Нет, ты позвони, спроси, скажи, я бедный, кушать нечего, когда у вас бесплатное. Просто позвони туда, да, спроси. Чё ты стесняешься? Тебя ж никто не видит. Скажи, приехал эмигрант, живу в сарае, денег нету, кушать нечего. Типа. Дайте колбаски, дядя. Ну, записался завтра в 7 часов на Крайслер, повезу, красавица, ну да, ровно 8 наличными. Не, ну, молодец, я тебе говорил, ставь 8,5, а ты такой, поставлю 7,5, я говорю, 7,5 поставишь, у тебя через 2 дня заберут. Да это вся херня, это ты знаешь, они ни хера, они придут, знаешь, когда человек приходит первый раз, машину видит, он хереет, она как новая для них. И чё, богатый, что ли? А, он тебе адрес дал? даже и не ездил никуда, да? Аюканом. Я тебе перезвоню. I'm knocking on the heaven's door. I'm knocking on the heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on the heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on the heaven's door. Who? I'm sober. Today is day 16, my friend.
I know that. I have another cigarette.
Are you coming? No, age before beauty.
Are
you alright? You alright?
Yeah. Melbourne Cup Day, what do you fucking expect?
You look good. You look fresh.
Huh? You look fresh.
Actually, when you drink, you know, it's good for you, you know? Good for the skin, you know?
I'll cut down the beer.
Beer. Do it like Felix do. If I drink, when I drink. Spirits, because I'm spiritual. I'm spiritual man.
Right, okay.
Only spirits, no bullshit beer. Beer, you know, beer is for junkies. Let junkies drink beer. Real people drink tequila, vodka, gin, whatever. 40%, should be 40%.
Where is
it, baby? Yeah, all right. Yeah, I understand, yeah.
Everything and everyone share a link. Consequently, what serves the greater good eventually benefits you as well. Thus, the Stoics firmly believe that those most in harmony with reason were the ones who dedicated themselves to the broader welfare. In other words, virtues. Contrarily, the absence of virtuous conduct is attributed to ignorance, according to the Stoics. When life propels you into unforeseen circumstances, virtues can be your guiding stars, directing you on the right path and keeping you grounded. This is why individuals most enriched with virtues often emanate tranquility and composure. To embody virtuous qualities, one must internalize the four cardinal virtues of Stoicism: wisdom, justice, temperance, and courage. In the Stoic perspective, wisdom is the ability to distinguish between good, bad, neutral, and everything in between. It entails transcending the sway of emotions, allowing reason to govern what is morally just. Confronted with a dilemma, wisdom empowers you to analyze both options with a clear mind. Next comes justice. Wisdom is the foundation of justice, containing a commitment to what is right and ethical for both oneself and others. The Stoics regard it as a duty to fellow humans and society as a whole. Courage enables action even in the face of adversity. It determines to act with gratitude or undertake tasks despite uncertainty about the outcome. Courage doesn't entail the eradication of fear, desire, or anxiety, but rather the conscious decision to proceed, surmounting emotional barriers. Lastly, temperance. Temperance signifies maintaining a balanced path between extremes. It's about exercising self-control, restraint, and discipline. Marcus Aurelius highlighted the human trait of self-regulation, setting us apart from animals. Temperance prioritizes long-term well-being over fleeting gratification. Consider a mundane example, a bag of chips. Indulging in the entire bag might bring momentary pleasure, but it jeopardizes health and even mood. Here, exercising temperance means pausing after a few bites. Wisdom is instrumental in gauging the right amount to consume before stopping. Stoicism categorizes things and actions into goods, evils, and indifference. Seeking the good, avoiding evil, and embracing indifference according to personal preference will guide your principles. Departing from these virtues equated to fostering evil, stealing, disrespecting, recklessness, or abstaining from good. Indifferent actions such as taking a leisurely stroll could neither, steps away can reveal an entirely different reality. In essence, when we detect and contemplate the grand tapestry of our world and existence, we realize how minute our personal experiences are, and how infinitesimal we are in the vast scheme of things. This shift in perspective unveils the expansive realm beyond our immediate encounter. Often people overlook the truth that their own encounters and viewpoints aren't the only ones deserving of consideration, even within their own lives. Consider someone who's had an unfavorable experience with dogs. They might find it challenging to fathom that dogs can be cherished companions to others, unless they deliberately acknowledge the possibility of diverse experiences. From time to time, it's imperative to step back and inquire, what am I neglecting or failing to grasp? This introspective practice bears multiple benefits. For instance, envisage having to choose between remaining in your current job or pursuing a newly available position elsewhere. Such a decision might seem daunting, especially if you're uncertain whether either option will fulfill your aspirations. While your current job offers stability, and you're wary of the additional responsibilities tied to a promotion, the allure of a better salary beckons. You might feel ensnared within this dilemma. However, a wealth of untapped prospects lies beneath the surface. Have you contemplated venturing into a completely different field, or exploring a side venture that complements your current job? Perhaps immersing yourself in a passion to shift your focus away from tasks you find less appealing. It's entirely plausible that numerous unexplored avenues in life are eluding your awareness. Adopting a panoramic perspective, rather than fixating solely on immediate concerns, significantly aids in informed decision-making. Broadening your scope isn't only valuable for determining priorities, but also for shaping your opinions. To form a comprehensive judgment, it's imperative to consider all facets and possibilities within a given situation. Moreover, stepping back signifies distancing yourself from personal biases and viewpoints. Temporarily relinquishing your desires can offer a fresh vantage point, prompting you to reflect on those around you and your responsibilities towards them. In the intensity of the moment, you might perceive an action like littering as inconsequential. However, when you pause and widen your perspective to encompass the entirety of the world and the potential consequences if everyone were to follow suit, the insignificance of your inclination to litter becomes starkly apparent in contrast to the well-being of the planet. As previously mentioned, the Stoics firmly believe in the interconnectedness of everything in the world, positing that the overall betterment of the world inherently contributes to one's personal well-being. Hence, taking a step back to embrace a global viewpoint, rather than solely focusing on your own life, holds immense significance. Confronted with a decision, adversity, challenge, or life-altering change, you have the capacity to pose introspective queries. Whether in the heat of the moment or later on, perhaps
So it's a Mondays. It's
yeah.
Every Monday.
Every Monday.
Really? From now?
Yeah.
From next week.
Next week.
Next week is first. Oh, lovely. Yeah, yeah. I'll show you with Max. Yeah.
Yeah, good.
Yeah. So it will be GP. GP. GP.
Yeah.
All right. Good.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Colin.
Are you coming too?
Colin Cheers.
Are you coming?
I'll be there.
Oh, see Colin.
Yeah.
Yeah. Felix. My name is Felix.
Felix. Yeah.
It's on my back. Yeah.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah.
Good.
All right. Yeah.
Yeah.
See you, Colin.
Day,
yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
мудрость веков от великого немецкого поэта и философа Фридриха Шиллера, в этом видео поможет вам обрести гармонию в жизни и найти ответы на сложные вопросы. Приятного просмотра. Вы на канале «Мудрость мысли». Утраченную минуту не может вернуть даже сама вещь. Человек вырастает по мере того, как растут его цели. Против мудрости бессильны даже боги. Умейте ждать, когда все придет в свое время и обретет свою цену. Сильнее всех побед — это прощение. Истина ничуть не страдает от того, что кто-либо...
Morning, Michael. Safe today?
I hope so.
Yeah. Fingers crossed. Go sandbag. Sandbag. Sandbag, please.